Like he would be he would thank people in the couches.
What?
Like in
people, the couches?
Like, police would be in the couches.
Damn.
And so like I'll be sitting on a couch and he'll come in and just start stabbing the couch next to me because he thinks there's someone in there trying to get
him. What?
Or like he'll kick my door in when I'm sleeping. And I'll have like a girl over or something.
Yeah.
And he'll spray my room because he thought we were all on fire.
Yo, yo, yo. It's YF Dizzy TV. You watching on YouTube. Listen on FBRN.us. Coming live from Globe Life Park. And it's a wonderful day. And before we get started, we got a good guest today. But before we get started, I got some good words for the people. You know, a lot of people my age, as of late, I feel like, have been giving up on their dreams. Have been just resorting to living a 9-to-5 and feel like they have no more potential. They feel like they're too old to chase their dreams. Or they don't know what they should be doing. But today I have a way for you to find exactly what you should be doing with your life. So, back in school, we had this thing called a Venn diagram, and for those that don't know, it's basically a little chart that has a couple of circles. For this one, we're going to need 4 circles. So on the first one, you're going to put what's something that you've been around since you grew up. When you was little or when you was young, what's something you've been around? Whether it's music, whether it's welding. Whether it's farm animals, something that you have grown up by has given you a lot of hours in it. And if y'all know the 10,000 hour rule, you know it takes about 10,000 hours for you to become an expert at anything. So if you've been doing this since you were a kid, you're probably really close to those hours. The second circle is, what's something you could talk about effortlessly on a Saturday night? Meaning, what's something you could sit down with your friends around the fire, or you know, just sit at the table and just talk about hours and hours and hours. That's probably something you'll be good at. The third circle is, what have you spent the last 5 to 10 years doing? If you're younger, around my age, it's probably the last 5 years. But if you're older in age, maybe the last 10 years. What have you spent the last 5 to 10 years doing? Because again, that's going to add to your 10,000 hours. 10,000 hours at anything makes you an expert. And number 4, what have you gotten positive feedback from other people outside your family or your closest friends? What have people outside your circle given you positive feedback on? So what you're going to do to figure out what you should be doing with your life is try to connect those 4 circles, find something in the middle, and that's what you should be doing. And to even reach a better level is put it into one sentence what you're doing with your life. What's your goal? See, for me, my one sentence is I'm trying to create great content. Whether that's the podcast, whether that's memes on the internet, whether that's potential music in the future or music videos, I'm just trying to create great content. That's just something I enjoy doing. So in order for you to figure out and have purpose in your life, see what's your one sentence. And then follow that and get back on your dreams. Because if you're around 25, 30, you're still not too old. Colonel Sanders didn't sell the KFC recipe till he was like 90-something. So he had 40 years on you, 50 years. So you still got time. But I do want to address something. I don't know if y'all noticed, today is releasing on Wednesday, but I'm recording on Tuesday. Monday, Instagram blocked hashtags. And most of y'all wonder why. And they say it's to stop the spread of disinformation. But that's kind of iffy because what type of disinformation are they stopping? You as an individual in the U.S., because they only did this in the U.S. because of the elections. The individual in the U.S., you got to see, if you are on the side of the oppressor, are you really on the right side? There is certain hashtags or groups or certain views that are being shadow banned. that are being just blocked on the internet, that are just being oppressed. And if you're on the opposite side, you're probably not on the right side. You're probably standing with the oppressors. You've probably been watching too much TV, been on social media too much, and you've been following the trend. You haven't been thinking for yourself. You've been following the flock. I'm not saying choose a certain viewpoint right now. I'm just saying take into account, look at what's being oppressed. That's probably something that they don't want you to look at. They're probably trying to form your mind a certain way. That's all I have to say on that topic. And we have one more topic before I get and bring on my guests. Why can women be hoes, but man can't? And let me explain to y'all. As a man, whenever you do what you need to do to sleep with a woman, it's never easy. You either gotta impress her, gotta have something of value, or you gotta get her to like you. A woman could be attracted off you off top, but she's not just gonna sleep with you. But women, y'all get laid simply because y'all have a vagina. So it's not hard for y'all to get laid. So that's why I believe that women could be considered hoes, but men can't. Men, on the other side, are players because it takes skill for a man to get laid at the same rate a woman could. Let me ask the women. Have you ever had to charm a man? Have you ever had to seduce a man? Have you ever had to take a man on a date and buy him flowers or take him somewhere fancy just so you could get laid? No. I bet if you hit any guy in your phone right now and say, hey, you want to come over? 99% of those men who are not in a relationship, even some that are going to say yes. The same is not true for a man. It takes skill for a man to be laid. That's why a man is referenced as a player, a Don Juan, because it takes skill. Women, y'all don't take skill. That's why it's considered a wholeness, because it's so easy. It takes no skill. You're born with a vagina. That's the skill you have. So, if y'all have any arguments, put it in the comments. Let me know what you think. But that's all for my two cents today. That's my intro, Wife Dizzy TV. When we come back, we have an amazing guest, a young up-and-coming artist, number two on Onto Urban's Potential Rappers of 2020. We're going to be right back, Wife Dizzy TV. All right, we back with Wife Dizzy TV. I'm here with Digiscale P. What's going on, my brother?
Hey, man, what's going on with you, man?
Hey, pull that a little bit closer to you, man.
I said, hey, what's going on with you, man? You know, my name is Digiscale P.
Tell the people where you from.
I'm really from Fort Worth, but you know, I be back and forth from like Fort Worth and Arlington.
Yeah.
And you know, so I grew up like half and half, you dig what I'm saying? So it's my partner actually just called me, man. You know, my brother, he in jail, and you know, he wanna, you know, say a little something, you know, on for my little interview. Hey, Alvin.
Hey,
go ahead, let these people know what you was going to say.
Oh, yeah, first of all, nigga, my name Alvin, and call me Lil J-Bo. Follow me on Instagram at Lil J-Bo, LILJYBO, Snapchat, 2real_3, TOOREALL_3. And shit, I just want to, know what I'm saying, let you cats know that, you know what I'm saying, y'all fucking with the real deal, you know what I'm saying, Pete. He a real good nigga, you know what I'm saying, he a hard worker, and he take his job seriously, so I just want to let you niggas know that. You know what I'm saying? I'm fucking with the real deal. I've been knowing this cat since I was about 14, 15. He's a real good dude. And he's a great artist, you know what I'm saying? So I advise you, you know what I'm saying, to go out there and listen to his music and follow him, tune in with him.
Yeah, man. So, you know what I'm saying, from the streets to the pen, we locked in, man. You know what I'm saying? Hey, I'm going to call you later. Just hit me up later, my baby.
Yeah,
All right, love you.
Hey, that's what's
yeah,
up, that,
that's my brother right there. You know what I'm saying? I got a couple songs with him. You know what I'm saying? Coming out, and you know all the music, all the money I make off. You know what I'm saying? The songs I got with him, you know, go to his books and, you know, his funds in there. You dig what I'm saying? So, you know, that's just how I'm coming from my people like that, you know?
Speaking of music, what got you into music when you first, like, how old were you when you first started music?
Well, you know, I used to box, you dig what I'm saying? And I don't know what came over me. It's probably like in seventh grade, sixth grade, I just really started fucking with, you know, I'm a YouTube internet baby. You dig what I'm saying? Like, I came out, like, you know what I'm saying, on an iPod Touch, you know what I'm saying, stuck in the house, I'm watching YouTube all day. You dig what I'm saying? So my music knowledge is just like, it ain't really like too much other, like, you know what I'm saying? My top five is so... I got to explore the internet. You dig what I'm saying? Like, I wasn't locked down to where, like, you know what I'm saying? It's like this new, it's like the new generation. Like we got to pick and find what music we liked. You dig what I'm saying?
What type of music you like?
Man, I like, man, I love rap, hip hop, whatever the fuck you call it. You dig what I'm saying? But, man, my the catalog and my top five, like, you might not even know some of the artists. You dig what I'm saying? But these are just the artists that, like, you know what I'm saying, shaped, I feel like shaped me. You know what I'm saying? I could always play and I could always listen to them. You dig what I'm saying? But what got me into music, I was boxing and on the cool, man. It was just like the music, the rock star lifestyle. Like, it was like, I'm not going to lie, I was like just starting experiments and, like, you know what I'm saying, selling drugs and doing this. And I was like, you know, I started selling drugs like 12, 13. You know what I'm saying?
Damn, like, you was out there as a baby.
Yeah, I mean, just a little weed and shit. You know what I'm saying? But I always been around it my whole life. You dig what I'm saying? Like my whole life, you know, all my family addicted to drugs, like on the needle. You know what I'm saying? Like, or in jail. For life, you know what I'm saying? I really don't got too much family, especially on my father's side, but you dig what I'm saying? So
do you think that influenced the type of music you make?
Oh, for sure. But the type of music I make is you know what I'm saying, like, I'm gonna take you there. Like I'm gonna take you there. Like if you not really, if you not really involved, or maybe even have done your research on what I'm talking about, then you'll be totally lost. You might, it might not even make sense to you. That's why I feel like, you know, it's not for, it might not be for everybody, but yeah, it's for show for a particular crowd. But anyway, I started really just taking it serious, like, sixth, seventh grade. And when I mean taking it serious, like, in my head, like, I wanted to be, like, the youngest to ever come out. Like, I was fucking with, like, Earl Sweatshirt. And, like, because he was the youngest, but he was, like, the most lyrical to ever come out. You dig what I'm saying? Like, and I was trying to be like that. Like, I wanted to be that. You dig what I'm saying? Yeah. So I would, like, engineer my own shit in a little closet. Like, bro, I wouldn't sleep. Like, I wouldn't sleep, I would sleep at school, you know what I'm saying? Because, like, my mama would tell me to go to bed. I'd put my laptop in my closet, and I'd just be sitting in my closet writing. Like, I hadn't, when niggas talk about they got notebooks, like, stacked in they closet, I really had notebooks stacked in my closet. Like, I really, like, was trying to perfect my craft because I came from boxing. So, like, it, like,
you had the discipline.
How, well, no, that's how I looked at everything.
No, I feel that.
That's how I looked at everything. And, like, I had to train. You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
you
I
had to discipline. Train. Like,
well, no, I, get like, after that's your how I craft. Came at it. Yeah. That's how I came at it. And that's how I come at everything. Like, you got to put the work in. You have to put the groundwork in.
Yeah, you got to.
And so, you know, I was doing that for a long time, and then, you know, I didn't really start dropping music until, I was probably, like, 16, something like that, you know what I'm saying, with my homeboys and shit like that, but it wasn't serious at all. And then, you know, like, shit, during that time, like, that's when I moved to Fort Worth and really got, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was really living in the slums, like, you know what I'm saying? Like really in the slums, you know what I'm saying? Like my dad was, like, the most terrifying crackhead on the block, you know what I'm saying? I watched my dad smoke crack rocks the size of tamarines. I used to go to school smelling like crack smoke, like minty crack smoke. You dig what I'm saying? Because, like, our house would be filled with it. Like, bro, I used to go to school smelling like crack smoke for real. Like, and
how you think that affected you?
Oh, it's so much more to that story. But, like, I got a hell of a story. I got a crazy ass story. But you dig what I'm saying? I wanna kind of save it and tell it through my music. And you dig what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And,
so, what's your motivation when it comes to music?
I wanna get paid to do music, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, I would trade. I got a passion for it. Like, I would trade everything to get paid to do music. You dig what I'm saying? Like, I would give up all hustling, you know, the jobs I work, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's the goal. But not only that, just to be a legend in the game. You know what I'm saying? I really want to be a legend in the game. I really want to be, like, you know, when you listen to me, like, I'm one of the hardest motherfuckers. I want to be, like...
Do you model yourself after anybody in the game right now?
Nah, man. I'm Digiscale P, man.
You just you.
I'm a
one of a kind.
I'm one of a kind, man. Cause no one can describe the game like I can describe the game.
Yeah.
Like, no one can describe the game like I can describe. Like, I haven't heard it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So that came from years and years and years of, you know what I'm saying, trying to find it.
Yeah.
But, it just was a lot of work, you know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of perfecting my craft and, you know, trial and error and, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I mean, I'm doing this shit until it worked. Like, I'm not stopping.
You do what I'm that.
Saying? Like, it's...
what's your goal? Where do you see yourself, man, in 5 years from now?
I want to be, like, one of the biggest artists. I want to be, like, a Kodak Black or you know what I'm saying? Like, a motherfucking something. Big, you know what I'm saying? I want to be the biggest. You know what I'm saying? I want, and then, boom, cash out and live my life. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I want to be a legend in the game.
Yeah.
I might not necessarily want to be the biggest. I want to be a legend in the game. I want to be someone like a Kodak Black. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, I would, like, that's the goal. You know
that's
what I'm saying? But I don't want to do it forever. Mm. You dig what I'm saying? I want to go do, you know what I'm saying? I want to get my meal ticket and go do something
dip
else.
Out,
you dig what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And because, you know, it's all type of other shit you could be out here doing.
Yeah. Shit, so we about to take a quick break. We got this song, How Much Money. You want to explain to people where it come from or what it means?
Oh, yeah, How Much Money, man. That's actually, this is the only beat that's not made by my executive producer. 100 made the beat. This is actually made by my engineer. You know what I'm saying? He's just, you know, recently worked with Mo3. He engineered, you know what I'm saying, all Rozelle Blackwells, or he helped him, you know what I'm saying, during that time. He's one of the baddest engineers in the game. But How Much Money, you know what I'm saying, it's one of my favorite songs. I feel like, you know what I'm saying, with the right push, and the right ears hearing it, it's for sure, you know what I'm saying, just for show, a million view song.
Maybe
redo the video or something. You know what I'm saying? But give it a listen, man. And if you know, it's the first full song, like, I can say I made. I crafted every part. You know what I'm saying? Crafted every part of it. You dig what I'm saying? So it's special to me. But y'all listen to that bitch.
YF Dizzy TV, How Much Money, Digiscale P. You tuned in to YF Dizzy TV here with Digiscale P. It's it's November 4th whenever this dropped, and I'm feeling good. So I got a few more questions for you. So I see you had an Instagram post with Heavyweight Hank, and you was telling me something about that.
Oh, yeah, man. Heavyweight Hank, you know what I'm saying? That started It's crazy. So it's crazy, like, especially the interview being today, man. Like, I was just with this person the other day, and whenever I was homeless, I had just started listening to, you know, CML. You know what I'm saying? At 3 years later.
Yeah.
You remember when I was staying over there at the Providence or with the, you know what I'm saying? With the one that was tripping out. And, so I was listening to him then. You dig what I'm saying? And so I linked up with that person last night. You know the close friends I just posted.
Oh.
Yeah. So anyway, yeah. like that person was there when I first discovered CML. Anyway, I've been a huge fan. Like I fuck with his music. You dig what I'm saying? And one day he had a little deal special. You dig what I'm saying? $1,000 for a verse. I hit him up immediately, and I was like, man, you know, I'm a fan, my nigga. Like, you know what I'm saying? Fuck with me. You dig what I'm saying? And I shot him the bread, sent him the shit, and you know, I flew out to Sacramento by myself. You know what I'm saying? And I had more jewelry than I had now. You know what I'm saying? Not that like mean nothing, but you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm a stand up nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. I'm, you know what I'm saying? I'm cool. I'm just here to do my music. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And so I paid for everything, Wooty Wop, and then you know, he had hollered at me. He was like, man, I fuck with you. He was like, you know, you came out here and did this on your own. He was like, he had told me that day, he was like, you know, when I get off all this shit, man, keep on working. I'm gonna come back and get you. You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And you know, niggas just be talking. I don't know him like that. I'm like, whatever. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Well, I real low key forgot about this shit, right? And so I guess he had just got off parole and shit, and he had hit me. He had hit me, and he was like, hey, where you at? And he was actually in Texas, and told me, come out there, come fuck with him. And man, it was you know, we got something going on in the works. You dig what I'm saying? Like, all my music is posted on his page. You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He got, you know what I'm saying? He supported me to the fullest. You know what I'm saying? I'm banked up. You know what I'm saying? I'm fucking with the, you know what I'm saying? I'm fucking with their movement. You dig what I'm saying? You know, I'm standing behind that shit. You dig what I'm saying? Because these are the ones who gave me a chance.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm saying? I'm loyal. You know what I'm saying? I'm loyal. My loyalty has hurt me a lot. You know what I'm saying? In the past. But you know what I'm saying? He, when I went out there, I just seen how hard he go for himself and for his people.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And it really, I'm the one to be soaking up game and really peeping shit out. You dig what I'm saying? I'm a watcher and a listener. You dig what I'm saying?
Well, that's what people say. You know, God gave you two ears and one mouth. You know, use them accordingly.
Yeah, for sure. And man, how I just seen him operate, I was like, okay, man, like this is how I want to come into the game.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm saying? So, you know, it's banked up, you know, when it come to Digiscale P. You know what I'm saying? Like that's just what it is with me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And, you know, I'm standing on that, and I'm going to, you know, make the brand look as best as I can and, you know, continue to pump out quality music. You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And, but, yeah, I fuck with him, man. I fuck with him tough, man. He gave me a chance. You know what I'm saying? And people don't got to do that for you.
Nah.
You know?
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's what that is.
So, let me ask you, what's the best advice somebody gave you, whether it come to rap or anything?
The best advice someone ever gave me? Man, I don't know. I mean, the best advice I know is that, yeah, I mean, it's either two ways. It's either everything starts with a thought or everything starts from zero. Mm. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, like, everything starts from, you dig what I'm saying?
The ground.
One.
Yeah.
Something. You know what I'm saying? It starts from a thought. It can go either way. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I say everything starts from zero.
Yeah.
Because, like, man, like, okay, man, it has to start at some point. You know what I'm saying? Whether it's change, whether it's fucking, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You're starting to buy lottery tickets. Like, You know what I'm saying? Everything started from
you just can't expect to come with a tree already when you just got seeds.
Yeah, and man, other than that, just I don't know. I mean, I hear a lot of great advice all the time. You know what I'm saying? Stay working.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, stay working.
Yeah.
But
so let me ask you. So, are you independent right now?
Yeah, I'm independent.
Plan on staying independent?
Or do you want to be signed? Man, I don't give a damn, man.
Just wherever the bread at, huh?
People coming through M's.
Yeah.
Man, I'm going. And what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to show these people I know what to do with this money. You dig what I'm saying? Because I know what to do with this money.
When it comes,
if you was to give me the money, I know what to do with it. I know how I'm going to do this. You know what I'm saying? I know how I'm going to do this. I know how I'm going to do that. And I wouldn't mind signing with a label. You dig what I'm saying? The thing about it, I just don't got too much music out.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like I told you, I'm going to give you an exclusive to drop today. It's fully mixed and mastered. And then I'm going to play another unreleased for y'all. But, man, whatever I see is best for me. You know, you dig what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I'm just gone.
You gotta watch out for number one. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you know, I'm just, you know, but I'm fucking with Banked Up. You know what I'm saying? Just really, just until it's, you know what I'm saying? Until I'm done. I'm like, till it's, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because these are the only people who gave me a chance.
Yeah. So let me ask, because I seen you was with BTF Hundo.
Yeah, BTF Hundo.
Yeah, got something coming out, or what y'all got?
Oh, yeah, we got a song coming out, man. You know what I'm saying? Me and him, frequent some of the same spots sometimes. You know what I'm saying? And I run into him pretty often, actually. And, I told him I rap, you know what I'm saying? He listened to some of my shit. He was like, I'm trying to get you on something. You know, we made a banger too, and we gonna do a video to that motherfucker pretty soon.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's turned up. But I fuck with a whole lot of niggas on 23rd, man. Like he did a song with Stove Top Smelly, like I think it was Brick Flow or something. But I used to coach his son.
What do you mean you used to coach yourself?
Because I used to box, but I also used to be a boxing coach.
Oh, for real?
Like, I did that for money.
You dig
what I'm saying? Like, I got all type of hustles. You know what I'm saying?
Was you nice on the mitts, though?
Man, what? Bro, nigga, I might be a nicer coach. I might be a sweeter coach than I am a sweeter fighter. Damn. And I'm a sweet-ass fighter, bro. I won world championships.
Damn. What weight class you be fighting in?
Whenever I was little. I was like 13, 14, I fought 138. I was number one in the world. I fought
one
from Russia, Japan. What's it called? You know Tristan Kyle Cruz?
Nah.
Virgil Ortiz?
Yeah, I know Virgil.
Man, I used to spar Virgil.
Damn.
He used to beat my ass. But he's the truth, though. That motherfucker right there.
Yeah, he a beast. He ain't lost yet, but. So you ever think about getting back into boxing?
Man, I might, but I'm really just gonna coach my son.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. My son's gonna be the truth. You dig what I'm saying? So
how you like being a dad?
Man, the dad thing, nigga, that shit took me a minute to adjust to. like, bro,
yeah.
I don't know, man, because the shit I came from.
Yeah.
Like I'ma just give you like I'ma just give y'all like a normal day. This is how I lived. This is how I lived my like high school last 3 years of high school. Like I graduated, you know what I'm saying? But this is how I lived my last 3 years of high school. I was living in Fort Worth with my pops and shit. He would be so throwed off. He would thank people in the couches.
What?
Like
in the couches?
Police would be in the couches.
Damn.
And so like I would be sitting on a couch and he'll come in and just start stabbing the couch next to me because he thinks there's someone in there trying to get
him. What?
He'll kick my door in when I'm sleeping, and I'll have like a girl over or something.
Yeah.
And he'll spray my room because he thought we were all on fire.
Damn.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I'm talking like every night.
Every night?
Yeah. And then like, man, he would like steal people bikes and this nigga would steal people bikes and just leave them in our front yard and shit. And then like, dog, like these niggas would be at my school like, bro, your bike's in my yard. I'm like, nigga, y'all know my dad is just going around here taking y'all bikes.
He gonna take
like,
y'all
like this is out of my control, bro.
You can just
like,
come get it, you know?
Yeah, like come get it. But nah, but my dad would be on hoe ass shit. Like he would be sitting out there.
What?
Like guarding his fucking prize, that stolen possessions, bro. This nigga was a goon, bro.
Damn.
This nigga was like a real life goon, bro. And but yeah, so that's like the type of life I live, like the type of things going on.
So that's why I took you a minute to adjust.
Well, and then so like with the baby and shit, damn, I feel like it's hair on my face. With the baby and shit, it just, it just didn't hit me, like, it didn't hit me, like.
It takes a while.
It took like 6 months into it.
Shit. It hit you quicker than me.
But I was bad, though.
For real. Shit, because they ain't hit me till like, he was like a year or something.
I was fucked up because I was still hurt. Because of the shit that happened with my dad. Like, my dad was in jail, capital murder, like, all type of shit.
Damn.
Yeah, it was all type of crazy. Like, I was real hurt. So, the love my baby mama was giving me, I wanted to be numb. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I wanted to be numb. Like, that's
you
how
don't
I
feel
get.
None of that.
I want to be numb.
Cause that's how you survived before.
Yeah, like, so the love she was giving me, I didn't want it. You dig what I'm saying? Mm. Like, I didn't want it, and it was just a lot going on. You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But, that's how that shit, you know what I'm saying? That's how that shit kind of, that's actually how we split up.
Damn.
And so, me and her, you know what I'm saying, goddamn me. I watch my son like what, 3-4 days out the week sometimes. No, every week. Every week, 3 or 4 days.
That's what's up, man. That's what's up.
But I still don't. But she put me on child support too, though. Isn't that crazy?
That is crazy.
That is pretty crazy to me.
If you got a majority of time.
I get it, but that's.
I mean, that's. I don't understand, though. If it's 50-50, I don't understand child support. Why you helping her with her 50 if, you know, you hold up your end?
Nah, but she cool, man. I love her, baby. My mom got nothing against
her. I mean,
she want that. That's cool. She got it.
I feel like that's one thing people don't understand, that you going to always have to love your baby mom because she created, you know, another you.
Nah, for sure. But some are going to be foul as fuck. But anyway, man.
Yeah.
Next question, man.
Man, we got this. We got another song right here. You said you got some unreleased for us.
Yeah, some unreleased shit, doggy. Which one?
We got Let It Pour.
Let It Pour? You want to do Let It Pour?
No, it's whatever you want, man. We got two of them. Residue or Let It Pour?
Well, look, man. We're going to drop an exclusive, man. This is... I'm going to drop Residue right now.
Okay,
this
bet.
Is me and Jigga. Jigga is like a... Jigga Big Brother is a real good friend of mine, right?
Yeah.
But Jigga can rap his ass off. Y'all finna see.
Damn.
And he the truth. And he went to the pen. I think he signed for 7 years. So, same case with Jigga. Mm-hmm. All the money, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
off his
gonna
shit.
Go to him.
Gonna go to him.
You that's what's up,
what
yeah.
And,
yeah.
100 made the beat on this one. What else? Hold on. 100 made the beat on this one. This is fully mixed and mastered exclusive. So this is gonna be out on, you know what I'm saying, Apple Music, all that shit, like in a couple days or something.
That's
and I'm gonna drop a couple more songs as well. So, you know, we're just keeping the ball rolling. But yeah, this is Residue. Digiscale P, Jigga, and this is off Digiscale Dreams, the EP.
Yo, 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 we back. Yeah, yeah, man.
Yo.
So how you feeling, man? When's that dropping?
When's that dropping? Man, that's dropping within a week. But it's gonna be like FOMO. I think like 3 or 4 more songs with it.
That's what's up, man. So it's like a mini EP or?
No, it's an EP.
For real?
Yeah, it's an EP.
That's what's up, bro. So, you know, I got a couple beats, and let's see, you know.
Well, no, well, we could do that at the end, man. You ask some more questions, you know what I'm saying? All right. You know what I'm saying? Let people get to know me, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So what do you think is, like, what made you become the person that you are? What are some things that happened that made you become who you are?
What are some things that happened that made me become the thing I am, man? I just been, you know what I'm saying? This lifestyle chose me, man. Like, whenever I was four, my dad, you know what I'm saying? I went on a run with my dad for 3 years from the feds. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He was, you know, I was sitting in the passenger seat while he run inside and robbed the pharmacy.
Damn.
For all the Excedrin and whoopie wop and all the pills needed to cook dope. And I literally remember this vividly. So to cook dope back in the day, you had to use like a blender to break down the pills, right?
Yeah.
Well, he had so many pills, he hooked up a lawn blower made.
A lawnmower blade. That's a big ass blade.
To a washer machine.
What?
And so then he broke.
Bro, he an engineer. He
filtered them out and shit. And, like, that's the type of shit my dad was on. You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
that's some smart ass shit, though.
The meth lab exploded whenever I was there.
All damn. Type of shit.
But anyway, like, shit like that. And then, like, whenever they came and got him, they were doing negotiations on the phone, like, and helicopters. And they fucking threw a fucking a gas grenade in the fucking house and shit. Yeah. Like, it was pretty fucked up.
Shit.
But shit like that. Like, man, like, I was born into this shit. You dig what I'm saying? And a lot of the shit I went through, I didn't have a choice. You did. So, what else? I'm trying to think.
Man, that's crazy as hell. You had a crazy ass childhood.
Yeah. It's pretty throwed off, man. Pretty throwed off. It's pretty dark, man.
Is that part of your motivation to, you know, get after the bread?
Motivation. You know, I mean, what was the question?
I'm saying, is that part of your motivation to get after the bread so you don't have to deal with stuff like that no more? All right. So we coming to the end of the YF Dizzy TV show, and we got a couple beats for you. So, you know, you said you could freestyle a little bit. So let's see what's up.
LP, this good dreams, man. You dig what I'm saying, man? I'm up in this bitch in the goddamn fishbowl, man. Gonna kick off this freestyle. Yeah. This good dream. Really so blessed to the fiend. Really we're pressing in prison apartment, fucking around with our seed. Really we're kicking in doors in the apartment if this nigga had what I need. Yeah. Did this get read? I feel the feet put up black and IV. Yeah. Did this get pee? Yeah. Really so black to the fiends. Really we're pressing in prison apartments if the nigga had what I need. Really we're kicking in doors in apartments if the nigga had what I need. Did this get drink? I held the feet put up black and IV. Yeah. Did this get drink? Got a spot rolling like hot curry cream. Infrared beam. All on the Glock. Just in the middle of the sea. Yeah. Life full of fiends of the method of penance. They take on for threes. Yeah. My bitch had sex in my sleep. My mama, she said that I got demons on me. I was back from here in a Roy rape. Now I'm in the kitchen with the unit with the flip phone trying to get paid. I don't believe a thing these niggas talk about me. I don't believe a thing they say. I still ride around with a flame. Can't let a fuck nigga put my brain. Did a scared dream. Close your eye, picture what I'm finna read. I stayed in the slum, oven for heat. But everywhere I turn on the oven, them murders would call like a devil they sleep. Sewage up out of the bottom, the shower, the step out of someone. Hold on, I'm fucking up, man. Hey, run it back, man. Nah, do another one. My fault, man. I'm fucking up.
Let's
These niggas thought doing something with a back though. Play it cool with them, never hit them with the back though. Used to be in the club, I'm smelling like crack smoke. Now I'm in a Houston with a mob and a black rose. I was in the kitchen, fuck around with the electro. Really gon' go put the cake to his cap though. I don't even see the need for it, cause it's cap though. Working like a chemist in the kitchen with a lab coat, Chicken and we rap though, Get a chicken and we rap though, Got a chicken and we rap though, I really go for the cap though, Fucking crazy. Must be fucking crazy, that's a seat dot. I really go for the red tips. All up a nigga thought. You ain't really got shit to say. You already know we on. Hey, do the Versace now, for real. Do the Versace now. We live right now. Hey, my bad. I'm fucking up like a motherfucker, though. Okay. Yeah, we're gonna keep this one right here. Hey, see, drain. Hey, how you gonna cheat the game if it's red? Strapped like a strap, but I'm crooked to my hip. Yeah, we still in the count, chopping 18 to the shit. I'm in the kitchen trying to flip counter to a 36. Freeze the microwave, freeze the microwave, freeze the microwave real quick. Man, it's all in the black. I sit down and I make it thick. And I'm Project Walls. If a fiend going get a fix. Balls deep in your bitch, she a fiend for the dick. Your bitch eating dick and ball. Kids leaking out of jaws when she done. Guess these niggas really thought that they was doing something. I don't even approve of something. Pull up on a chopper, bullets knock the thongs out these stupid nigga butts. Calibrate the lasers, easier to flame them when he run. Only calculation P doing is the profits on the drugs. Only patient P's and P using is the patience for the sluts. Saying that shit we on, boy, we don't really give a fuck. He say that, man, that's crazy, man. Man, you must be fucking crazy. If that's some shit you thought, I really put these red tips all in the nigga thoughts. Y'all gotta sit and know the shit that we be on. You ain't gotta pick a test shit, dog. Just go pick your coffin. And plan on robbing me, go ahead. Life insurance policy while you plotting. Pick a cool pose for the laws, write the chopping. I'm in the mountain, got some cool bowls, I'ma put them in boxes. Bitch, before you touch the car, touch your wallets in your pockets. Before you call, really think about why you calling. In them apartments, balling, I don't hold a spalling. Stalking this, got him looking around, he can feel us watching. Fucked it over up in the sink trying to wash it. How fuck I thought she threw up, she was trying to swallow it. Masking choppers, fully glocks with all the oddies. Masking choppers, fully glocks with oddies. Trying to fuck a nigga day up, and I'ma give him all it. Banked up, got my thumbs up in the air mobbing.
Yo, did you kill Pete?
Yeah, I can't freestyle, you know what I'm saying, but some of that shit might have been hard.
Yeah. Any last things you want to say to the people?
Hey, did we play?
We finna play on the outro. That's
okay,
how we
okay,
get
okay,
out
okay.
To,
the
to
little outro and shit. Yeah, man. You know, I was just kind of bullshitting on the little freestyles right there.
Anything you want to say to the people?
Man. Hey, look. Man, like I said, man. It's just so crazy, man. The way. You know, if you really visualize, I'm speaking to the youth, I'm speaking to anyone, you know, trying to do the same thing I'm doing, man. And you know what's so crazy? I had dreams and I would visualize that, you know what I'm saying? My boy Heavyweight Hank, CML, Lavish D was gonna holler at me and sign me to Banked Up. Like, this man's a living testament to that. Like, I would talk about this, like we would talk about this and bring it up. You know what I'm saying? That's just, like, I'm a living testament. So, man, really manifest this, man. Like, you can manifest this shit, and it can really happen. You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I was on a real dark path when I got the call from CML, man. Because, you know, God work in mysterious ways, man. You dig what I'm saying? So, man, don't give up. You know what I'm saying? set goals, accomplish your goals, you know what I'm saying? It's going to get overwhelming, you know, shit's not going to go according to plan. Everything starts from zero. You dig what I'm saying? But man, just learn from your mistakes. Anything's possible. And I got some new music coming out, Digiscale Dreams, the album. That's going to be about 20 songs. You know, I don't have a release date for it yet. What do we got going on right now? Leak, what do we got going on right now? The EP, I'm just really dropping singles. I'm getting all my Apple Music, Spotify, all that shit, and my YouTube all together. So y'all just stay tuned, look out for that. And, you know, follow me on all social media, Digiscale P. Mm. And, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Huh? Oh, yeah. Oh, South by Southwest, you're going to see me there whenever it get back open. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
that's about it. Hey, and anyone want to get in contact with me for features, you know, you in the city, you outside the city, man, you know, just holler at me. Go to, you know, it's all good.
And I appreciate you coming on, man.
I appreciate you having me, baby.
Man, this is... Hold on, I picked the wrong one. You said Let It Pour, right?
Yeah, Let It Pour. This is an unreleased track. Hasn't been too much mixed and mastered, but, you know, give me y'all feedback. Do y'all like this type of shit, or do you like that more harder shit?
All right, this is YFDizzy TV with another episode number 4. I'll catch y'all next week. Shout out to Digiscale P, and shout out to Malik in studio. We out.
Peace.